Hey everybody.
Tilly the comic here. How you doing? I'm wearing glasses and makeup. And look at, you can actually see the counters. So, hey, already winning round two or episode two. Okay, so I'm boiling water. Today we are going to make whore's pasta, also known as pasta puttanesca. It is what poor people eat in Italy. It's essentially garlic, tomatoes, and basil. I add more to it afterwards, but we're going to start with the basics and then we'll get funky with it. This is boiling. I grew my own tomatoes and I have to peel the skins off. This is the first time I'm doing this. Usually I make this with the skins on because I really don't care. But stick them in boiling water for a minute and then plunge them into cold water. I really hope this works. Also, I have to get this done before my son gets out of school in 30 minutes. Yes, I have started drinking. This is a little bit leftover mint from my garden. Half lime white claw, half ruby red grapefruit white claw. Let's call it a basic Tilly. Why not? That's its new name. Also, I have to shout this out. Look at my beautiful straw. It's really durable. Sawtooth Glassworks here in Boise, Idaho. I have special effects like I'm in a rap video. Oh, yeah. I wore this shirt because I'm wearing sweatpants, but if you get bored, you can look at my cleavage. Okay. So. You can actually see what I'm doing. This part's a little stressful for me because I've never done it before. Okay, so I had some water chilling in the freezer just to try to make it easier. I might have to do this in shifts. See? Rocking the sweatpants. Okay, sorry. I digress. Okay. Here you go. These are my babies. I'm so proud of them. I grew them. Spent a lot of time growing a little bit, but what the hell, right? Three, okay. So, from what I understand, you don't want to add too much to the water because it'll drop the temperature a lot. So, worked in kitchens for, not kitchens, but restaurants for a while, so I would always bug the chefs, like, teach me something, please. Help me at home. Okay. Got my tongs. Ooh, I forgot. I gotta put on my favorite music to make Italian pasta too. Okay, hold on. Moonstruck soundtrack. Timer just went off. All right. I'm gonna plunge in the ice bath for a minute. Put it in the freezer just to get extra cold. Cover this so we don't lose too much heat. And I'm just gonna do that in shifts and then I'll show you kind of how I'm peeling stuff next, okay? Keep drinking, keep listening to the soundtrack because it's the bomb. All right, it's not very cold, but let's tip it down. All right. Ooh, it actually comes right off. Holy crap, it actually works. These are some of the tomatoes. I think these are the San Marzanos that I grew, that are this long, kind of stringy tomatoes. Okay. This is pretty cool that it actually worked. Washing my hands. I don't know where my napkin went, so I guess I'll use this. Nothing to see here. Okay. take these guys out. Put these guys in. Oh, that one popped. Shit. Gotta be careful with these ones. These ones are ready to burst. They're little tiny guys that probably could have been bigger, but this year I just did not have the best luck in my garden with the tomatoes. I had a lot of spider mite issues. I could not get the watering down to save my life. Real talk. Like, ugh. It was a shit show. So, I am preparing dinner. My husband's coming back from a long emergency trip, so I thought I would make him some yummy pasta. I love my husband. We've been together almost 15 years. However, I love it when I give him a specific instruction, and he decides to interpret it into his own thing. And I like to tell him, honey, if I wanted it interpreted, I wouldn't have chosen the English to dumbass translation. I know, I'm a bitch. So I've got the water boiling for the pepper right now. And then I've got most of the tomatoes done. I just gotta peel those little guys. And if you don't have your own garden, just buy some cheap crushed tomatoes from the store. Here. I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty proud of the fact that I can do this, because I've never done this before. I just kind of chewed up the skins or made them really small by blending it. But it's nice to know that, hey, I got some skills now. And again, I've lived in this house for 10 years. I've been building my garden slowly and erratically for 10 years. I've been fixing up the house for 10 years. We just overhauled our yard. Oh my god. Literally this. Basically for the last 6 months, I've been like a pale, braless, like Sasquatch, just slowly moping through the yard, my tits are swinging. But the yard does look fantastic. I took a screenshot of my writing log. There was definitely, you could tell those 2 months of like complete just artistic breakdown of like, fuck this, it's over, everything's done. And luckily there's been lots of comedians pushing and inspiring, and thank God for you guys, because I don't know what we would have done without you. All right, I'm gonna do this pepper now. Okay, throwing the pepper, gotta time it, otherwise I'll just keep talking and forget about shit. Cheers, everybody. Oh, I'm doing horrible on timing, but we'll just make it work. Once the pepper's done, I'm gonna use the same pan, because I love these kind of pans, any sort of like big, wide deep pot is great for making pasta. You can literally do everything in it. Although I do cook the pasta noodles in something separate. I just want to get tomato juice in my drink, in the basic Tilly. Which, by the way, for those of you who don't want, are just skipping through, is mint, lime white claw, and ruby red white claw. No affiliation with White Claw, but if they want to throw me some money, hey, I drink a lot of your shit. All right, the pepper looks as wrinkled as it did before, but I'm going to put it in the water and get in the freezer just to try to get it extra cold and see if that will help. It's like leather. But okay, turned off the heater, and then I'm going to start, for you vegetarians, you can cut out this portion, but for the meat eaters, I'm going to be sauteing up some sausage, and because I'm ghetto and we have some
of it. I'm gonna chop up some hot dog and put that in there as well.
All right, got some fabulous opera going on. So I got my pan heating up over medium heat. Little cheat, like the crushed tomatoes. Before I said use one or two of those cans of crushed tomatoes. You can buy the cheap stuff or you can buy the organic stuff. Whatever you're feeling for yourself, okay? But I'm trying to do this as cheaply as possible since it is technically horse pasta, cheap pasta. So, one thing I recommend is you don't have to use pure olive oil if you want to save some money. Cut it with canola oil or whatever other oil, clear oil you like. Not coconut oil though, because that's not the right flavor profile you're going for. Instead of getting like a big ass thing of olive oil that's cheap, it's most likely rancid. I learned that fun fact. Americans are used to having expired olive oil. It's because we're never around it. There is a good California brand that I was heard is rated that's pretty fresh. And it's called California Olive Ranch. And you can buy a small jar and then just cut it with a bigger thing of canola oil. Put it in a wine bottle and use a little bar top. Mix it, put it in. That's what I recommend to save some money. That way you have one nice jar of olive oil that you use just sparingly rather than a lot that kind of tastes okay. And I'm someone, the funkier the olive oil, the better. That means it's fresher, it's dark, it's rich. You can dip bread in it with some salt, a little balsamic oil, pepper, rosemary, basil, whatever you want. Oh my God, that shit's good. Crushed tomatoes, whatever. Anyway, I'm like riffing here. Okay. That's heating up, so I'm going to add a little bit of my olive oil that's kind of fresh. Again, not paid for this, but just good recommendation. Got that. I'm going to put in my canola oil. So the reason I'm putting the oil in and then adding the meat is because I want to impart some of that flavor from the meat. I like spicy sausage. You can use Italian sausage if you want. I like hot sausage. I use Jimmy Dean hot. It's kind of basic. That's me, obviously, you know, the basic Tilly. But, so you're going to get this crumbled up. Then I'm going to chop up the hot dog into really small pieces because you don't want it super big. And then we'll skim it off, keeping the oil in there with all those flavors in there. And then we will add some garlic to the pan, and I actually grew our garlic. So this is tiny garlic, right? Depending on when you plant it, depending on when you pick it, will depend on the size. It's something that is very easy to grow, very easy to get. Get some organic garlic, like one head of organic garlic, break it up into things. Keep the bottoms pointed down and the little top points pointed up, and plant it in the fall. And you can keep it on a windowsill if you want, if you don't have another space like that. Oh my God, this is such a good part of the song. Shh, AJ, stop. My dog is attacking him. Anyway, so I'm gonna be gross and now you can add spices to the meat if you want while you're cooking it. Washing my hands. Got some food porn ASMR, just sausage crackling. By the way, one of the reasons that I, format my videos to the phone is that I'm guessing there's a lot of parents hiding in their bathrooms on their phones, taking the world's longest shit, seemingly, for their children. I do it. My husband does it. My dad did it. My mom. And I think also, as like, if you're married or with someone, a partner, also hiding from them, too, let's be real. This cooked up really fast, which is second. Leave it in there. Woo! Shit, that was real. All right. Anyway, I don't even know if that's playing or not. Okay. So I'll show you what it looks like if I can. So let me get this back on for us because it keeps dying and I'm not sure why. Play. Okay. I feel like I should have presented the sausage to the camera. Okay, so we got that. Now, we're gonna scrape up off, and you're gonna press the meat kind of against the side of the pan and tip the pan and try to get that grease away. I kind of put it up on the edge. Oops, sorry, I can't see. I like to put it up on the edge here. So it kind of naturally takes it down without making the sausage spill. And then after I transfer the sausage, I will actually get the grease at the bottom of the sausage too once it collects and pour it in. So it's a very tense situation and the music is fitting to try to get all the sausage in here. Now remember, go the budget route that you feel comfortable with. I reuse a lot of old stuff. I will use whatever meat's handy. I buy the cheap pasta if I have to, you know. Or you can go super fancy with it and go upscale. And get, you know, handmade pasta at the fancy Albertsons or another place in another city where it has more amenities than Idaho. But anyway, so I'm going to keep this and I'm going to kind of tilt it to one side inside a basket. Well, inside something that will hopefully actually keep it tilted. Okay.
I love jerry rigging stuff, so there we go. Just like this is jerry rigged to the banana holder. Okay. Anyway, now we're going to heat the pan back up again, add a little bit more of our mix, and cook up some hot dogs. I got these crazy hot dogs at Costco. I could start an OnlyFans page with it if I wanted to. Ew. Okay. And you know, there's some guy on the other side. That's pretty ass. I'm just kidding. Okay. Just kidding, guys. Just kidding. So, slicing up the dog. I'm probably not going to use all of it because it's pretty big and I can use it for something tomorrow, but I am going to touch it up into small, so if you can see, oh god, alright, if you can see it, nope, oh, okay, and we're back, okay, there we go, alright. Nice and small. Protect your fingers. Cook this up quick. Alright. I'm gonna have to edit here because I'm getting low on film. I'm still learning this shit. Okay. Handheld for a minute because I just can't be fancy to save my life. Alright. There we go. Again, there's our tomatoes. Again, there's the soundtrack we like to listen to. Again, there's the things that don't sponsor us. There's our meat. You can see grease collecting right down there. Okay, I have to set down the phone now because it just went a little nutso. All right,
This is brown. And it's angry. Turn it off for a second so it doesn't get too mad at me. Add this to here. Let that drain down as well. I'll show you how brown it is in a second. All right. Next, I'm going to make myself a drink. Another drink. And then we are going to start sauteing up the veggies. Oh, shit. And I forgot about the pepper. Oh, my God. Okay, let's see what happens. Let's see if we get this bitch peeled, huh? All right. Well, it's cold. It's kind of shrunk. And it kind of peels. It's not great, but I think it's better than nothing. It's almost like a sun-dried pepper, which is kind of cool, too. It's very interesting. It's very interesting, to say the least. And I don't want to waste too much of it. You can ask my family. I get very guilty if I waste any food. Anyway, okay, well, I'm gonna kind of hack at this. I don't know if it's worth the camera time for that, but we'll see. We'll try one and see if the peel is coming off at all. If we can get it to go, maybe not. I don't know. Well, okay. Still gonna use it in the sauce. It'll still taste good. So, all right, coming back. Okay, there's actually hope. As I turn the film on, I peeled sort of. I'm trying to tear at it instead of cutting it, I'm tearing at it, and I got it to peel a little bit. So I'm gonna keep doing that for a minute and see if that works. All right, checking back. All right, you can see how successful I was with these. I lost patience. In fact, I need to finish what I set out to do earlier, making the basic Tilly. Bam. So good. Anyway, so I'm just gonna kind of start this, hack this up, and I do all this kind of cooking in shifts. Sometimes I have my shit together and have all the stuff prepped, but obviously with a cooking show, I'm gonna just show you actually how I hack at it. It's better if you have a sharp knife. This one's getting dull, but I love this knife. I do love this kind of knife. Anyway, and I'm keeping my fingers away. Again, I'm really not too concerned how perfect this stuff is. I don't think any chefs would want to watch me because they're cringing right now. Anyway, but it's almost like I have these wonderful roasted red peppers. Now, like I said, garlic, low maintenance, easy to grow yourself. The red garlic is just so wonderful. Okay, so I'm just going to shoot it across. Take these little guys off. I got my pile here of stuff for composting. Just because I have a garden and a composter. You don't have to do that. I'm not Martha fucking Stewart. I don't, you know. But God, I love the fact that she's a stoner now. Like, oh, amazing. Like, a comedy writer could not have written it better, and her and Snoop together are just magic. Pure magic. Fun way to test if your oil's ready is just to flick a little bit of water in it. Now, there's lots of ways you can get this off. Usually I just smash it, but since I grow it, these little things aren't too, they're not going to affect the pasta sauce at all, because my shit's all natural. All right, so just like my titties, if you're bored. Okay. So I like a good garlic press. Some people would say cut it up. Sometimes I'm in the mood to cut it up. Supposedly, if you cut it up, it imparts more flavor. But we'll see. You're singing along to a all right, music so video. I'm doing this. Squeeze it right in.
this in. I'm going to throw the peppers in so the garlic doesn't get too burnt right away.
Claw down.
Yep, already. Okay. Now, I'm letting that cook. Once this gets really kind of yummy and pungent, I'm going to add a little more garlic and a little more tomato. Okay, so I forgot to mention that I used about 2 bulbs of garlic, but they are small garlic, so you could probably use 1 bulb, which is the whole cluster, or if you're not super into garlic, just a few cloves. Like, these were my cloves. These are the store, like, mutant cloves, right? So I'm adding a couple of those too, just for a slightly different flavor. And these ones, for you, just to your knowledge, these have been sitting for months, okay? These have been sitting for weeks. So, it definitely makes a difference in the flavor, the depth of flavor, as well as just how vibrant the flavor is. We love this stuff in our house. I think it's like Russian red or something like that. So I drained the roasted red peppers and put them on top of the sausage and all that schmear, right? And I'm gonna press these guys in here now. And then I'm gonna start adding the miters. I put it actually on like medium to medium low for this portion of it, just because I want to develop flavor slowly. And yeah, just want to make it more intense flavor. So then I'm going to add the sausage grease in just a second. If you are somewhere where you are affected by fires, we live in a valley and the air's gotten better, but boy, my throat is crashed. Oh, thank God for booze. Okay. So, whoa, shit. I've gone rogue. Okay. So, someone says, Steph, why aren't you drinking red wine? I only have cooking wine in bottles that's cheap as shit, but it's good for using on the fly. Okay. I'm going to get this off for just a second. And I want to use this. So let's see how much oil we saved. Come on, don't do this to me. Don't make me look bad. Uh-oh, my son's friend is here. Okay, there we go. It's coming out. It's hard to see. There you go. Flip it. Smack it, rub it down. Nope. All right, so there is the garlic cooking in. You can tell it's kind of tinged brown with some of the sausage and the burnt garlic oil. So it's going to be good oil to start cooking. I'm going to add a little bit more. It's okay to have a lot of oil in this stuff because it's good for you. Okay? Fats are healthy. Anyway, okay, now we're going to get it up a little bit. And then we're just going to throw these bad boys in here and start kind of mushing them up. Yes. Okay. So I'm just going to kind of keep cooking this down. And then I'm just going to start adding handfuls of spices, and I'll show you when I do that, okay? First, we got to add salt to this, get them to cook, break down a little bit. Okay, got that. Just, it doesn't matter. You can't really add too much salt. You can add a little bit of garlic powder. I like granulated garlic from Penzies. I'm a big Penzies fan. Shout out to them. Got a couple old tomatoes that are kind of funky from my garden. I can save these for slices for sandwiches. And I'm going to throw them in the sauce, but instead of boiling them since they're already cracked, I'm just going to cut the nasty part off and then squeeze out the insides into this pot, okay? All right. You can kind of tell the difference between the Cherokee purples and the other Romas and the San Marzanos. And the other ones, I don't know what the names of those little round red ones are, but they're beautiful. Anyway, they actually look like these when they're in the unripe stage. Anyway, all right, so that's all cooking, mushing, and next we're going to go to the garden. I lied. So what I'm doing is I'm mushing up all the tomatoes. Now, I usually blend my pasta sauces, just the veggie portions of it, just because I have a kid and it's easy to blend in broccoli and peppers and not have to worry about him fussing. But I also like a rustic sauce, a rustico, which means there's going to be some chunks in it and stuff. So I think tonight I'm going to go rustic for my hubby and for us. And my kid can just suck it up and be a big boy. It's going to taste good, so I'm not too worried. All right, so I'm going to turn this part down. Oh, I wish you could be here to smell this. It smells so freaking good. Once again, I don't own the rights to this shit. Any of this shit. Okay? Don't sue me. All right. Heading out to the garden now. Oh. Blind. Okay, this is my happy place. I have a gate to prevent the dogs from pooping in it. I have gravel everywhere to prevent weeds from growing in it. I just, those are my house plants, and these are some that I'm selling. Friends. So I'm gonna get some basil from the garden and I'm gonna get some rosemary from the garden. You can get these store, ask a friend who works at a restaurant, whatever you want to do, okay? I just cut off some rosemary. I love basil. It's the best smelling thing in the world. I'm gonna be making some pesto at some point. I like a fair amount of basil. It tends to get kind of small in, and I like to cut off the tops because if you cut off the tops, if you cut off the tops, they won't go to seed quite yet, and you have more growing season. Isn't that a fun fact, right? Kind of bonsai tree it, make it go down, and make it look nice and fluffy. All right, that's plenty of basil. I got plenty of rosemary. Let's head back real quick. Those are my raspberries. Can't really see because it's not focusing. So, the inside. I got this saute in still, or it's really broken down nicely, if you can see. You can see, so it's still, you know, like a crushed tomato sauce for you people who want to do it, you know, on the cheap. Okay. And I'm just still mushing it. Again, you can blend it to make it like that, you know, store-bought consistency if that's something your family can handle better. This is pretty cheap too, like, especially if you use the store-bought, you know, pre-canned stuff. I know this is clean. I don't have to pre-rinse it because I just watered it today. I'm just going to take it here. I don't know how much you saw of that. Okay, I'll do some more just in case. So, just as fine as you want it to be, okay? All right, throw it in, boom, okay? It looks like this, okay? Big old handful in there. I'm gonna add more as we go. I like to add some fresh stuff towards the end. So I got my basil, okay? Now I'm gonna add my oregano, which is right here, okay? Oregano, it's getting old. I need to get some new stuff. I could grow it, but sometimes the dried stuff's good. I usually dry my basil and try to save it for winter time. Again, very Martha Stewart-y, not something you have to do. I'm just trying to be a homesteader, that's all. Okay, so I'm putting an F load in there. Okay, I will show you again. Let me take this out just to show you. Okay, see that? I covered it. I might add more later. There's still a little bit left. I also have some old, like, freaking Italian seasoning and a little tiny bit left there. So it's going to make do.
So I got this saute, right? I'm not trying not to overcook it when I'm trying to have to stop the film. Chopped up my fresh rosemary. It's a big pot. You're probably using two of those cans of crushed tomatoes, so it's going to be a big pot. You want a good handful to give it some good flavor. Okay, so we got the basil, we got the oregano, and we got the rosemary. I'm going to add a little bit more basil because I can. Again, on the cheap, dried is fine. You're just going to have to use a little extra, okay? See if you have any friends with gardens like me. I will gladly give you some fresh basil, okay? So I got that going on there, okay? It's pretty. You can see the chunks of garlic in there. You can see some seeds, which is funny to me, but oh, it's seeds, but I don't really care about the seeds. Some people do. I do not. Okay. It's beautiful. Okay. Now that all the those are all in, I'm going to add some pepper, which I should have some. Where is the pepper? Where is Senor Pepper? Ah. We have Luchador salt and pepper shakers. Senor Sal, Senor Pepper. I know there's a different word in Spanish for this, but I still like calling them that. Got them at the Record Exchange here in Boise, which is an awesome local business. I'm going to add a ton of pepper because I like it. And just gives it a good depth. I can add a little bit of onion powder. I can add actually a little bit of lemon pepper to brighten it up. Where is my onion powder? Again, loving the Penzies, but I just reuse these jars too, and sometimes I'll get bulk from Winco or whatever. Winco is the cheapest to get bulk when the pandemic is not letting, you know, I think they're letting bulk now back, which is nice. Okay, so I'm stirring that all in. Now I'm going to add my peppers and my meat. Okay. I love the way this looks. I should probably keep it off. But, okay, so you can see I'm knocking, you can hear I'm knocking shit over, but I got the dogs, the tomatoes. If you're using two cans of tomatoes, the crushed tomatoes, yours might be looking a little bit more red than mine. Little less thick, perhaps, but I love it the way this looks. I like a really nice, hearty pasta sauce. So really, it is pretty much done. I mean, like I said, it is really just basil, tomato, and olive oil and garlic. So now it's just tweaking the spices for your own taste. Also, you can add wine. I'm going to get this up a little bit more bubbly. Get it to where it's kind of low grade bubbling. Not, you don't want to do it too high and separate it too hard, but you want to get it nice and bubbly. And then we're going to add some vino. Oh yeah. And it's cheap shit, so don't stress about that. On like medium low, I'm going to set a timer for like 3 minutes just to check on it. And then while that's cooking, I'm going to go grab the wine quick.
All right, kids, I turned it down. This is the part where I like to taste it. Sometimes I like to add broccoli to add more vegetables, but since I did red pepper this time and I got the hot dog, I'm going to try it. And my husband just got home from a long trip, and my son is happy. I'm pretty happy with the flavor. So I'm just going to add a little bit of wine. You can add as much or as little depending on how you like the flavor. This is really cheap shit. You can use leftover good shit that's bigger. I really like a big red. You can find big reds for cheap. Just go for like Zins or something like that. Sorry about the background, but I'm happy for them. But anyway, it looks freaking amazing. It's a nice chunky one. All right, so here we go. The music has stopped, but I'm just gonna add, like I said, just a splash like that. It really makes a nice color. It really, and again, add a little funky smell to it. You can keep tweaking with garlic powder, Italian, you know, seasoning, whatever you need to. Again, do it on your budget. Crushed tomatoes, basil, garlic, and get the fresh garlic. I mean, try to get as many fresh ingredients as you can, or if you have like one can of crushed tomatoes and some tomatoes that are going bad, use that, you know, and just take off the skins and squeeze them off. Crush them with your hands. That's what I do. So anyway, y'all don't need to see a finished product. This is it. It's going to saute in here, cook in here on low for probably about 5+ more minutes. And then this is the very dramatic dogs who are not pizza. I know. Okay. Anyway, I hope you enjoy your pasta puttanesca however you decide to make it. Just remember to do it all in shifts and it'll make your life easier. Like do parts, you know, first saute the peppers, then the sausages, etc. Or if it's all vegan, just start sauteing up different vegetables at different times. All right, this is Tilly the comic saying cheers. Fuck it. The next show will be cookies, because I make those all the time. And yes, once again, no weed in them. Sorry.